Hello, my name is Ian Dobson. I'm the Director of System Architecture within our Timing and Synchronization Division here at IDT. And I'm here to talk to you about the third generation of our programmable universal frequency translators. As you can see from the part numbers, there are three members of this family at the time of this recording. There will probably be more by the time you're looking at this. Our third generation is extending our universal frequency translator family that's been out there solving problems for customers for over 3 years now. One of the hallmarks of the family is that it takes any input frequency and generates one or more independent output frequencies that are unrelated to that input frequency. Within the family, we have devices that support 1, 2, 3, or 4 PLLs within a single package. The devices are all extremely flexible and programmable and can be used as frequency synthesizers that accept their input from a low-cost, readily available quartz crystal, or they can also act as a frequency translator or jitter attenuator, accepting up to 4 input reference clocks that can be anywhere in this third generation from 8 kHz all the way up to 875 MHz. The family has a number of benefits. They're fully programmable and can be reused in many different applications and different markets. There are up to 4 input reference clocks. These clocks support automatic hitless switching to enable redundancy and system availability. There are multiple options within this family that allows the device to power up without any complex user programming and run straight from power up. In our third generation family, we've added a new mode to that that allows us to support customer programming via an external EEPROM, much as you do for your FPGAs. And of course, one of the main attractions of the device is it supports extremely low RMS jitter on all its outputs for any of those demanding applications out there. At IDT, we recognize over the last few years, the clock tree has become much more complex in many of the designs out there. But our emphasis is that we want to solve these complex clocking problems simply. So with our third generation of the UFT, we're providing a highly flexible device that will allow support from multiple different configurations, multiple applications, and multiple different markets within a single device. The high integration that you see on our 282 device in the block diagram here, there are multiple functions that are combined within a single small package. We're able to generate high performance clocks from independent sources like fundamental mode crystals with RMS jitter less than 0.3 picoseconds. And with our IDT Timing Commander software, we've now made programming of a complex, flexible device like this very simple. This device was originally developed with communications line cards applications in mind. However, we have seen this device and its predecessors used in many different applications across many different market spaces, including some example applications listed here. Of course, one of the key features of the device is it's able to generate high-performance clocks. We're able to generate clocks that can serve as references for the high-speed PHYs, switches, and other demanding applications that are out there today. Clocks that have less than 0.3 picoseconds of RMS jitter. These output frequencies can be synthesized using an inexpensive fundamental mode crystal, a crystal running anywhere from 10 MHz to 40 MHz and generating outputs that are completely independent of that crystal frequency, allowing you to use a crystal that's already on your approved parts list. The output frequencies can also be synthesized from any one of up to 4 input references per PLL. These input references can be very high jitter or maybe even gapped input clocks, such as you see in the OTN space, and still generate that level of performance on the outputs. One of the things we're particularly excited about with our third generation of the UFT family is a breakthrough fractional output divider technology that we're using within the device. A fractional output divider allows the output clock to be independent from the frequency of the PLL, and we can now do that with less than 0.7 picoseconds of RMS jitter, even in that very flexible mode of operation. So speaking of flexibility, this same device can be used in many different configurations, many applications. We're able to generate outputs with or without input references. We're able to support reliable, redundant operation within the system. We have independent input monitors on each of the inputs and can support flexible switchover and holdover capabilities on a per PLL basis. The support for gap clocks allows the device to interoperate with OTN mappers and PHYs, as well as supporting the often complex frequency translations needing in the OTN space. The loop bandwidth of the device is programmable. This allows by a simple register adjustment to change the loop bandwidth of the device without need for changing any of the external components outside of the device. As you can see from our Timing Commander screenshot here, from our software configuration tool, there are many different signal paths throughout the device. And using this tool, a user is able to simply set up however they want to be able to configure the device for their particular application. There are independent dividers on each output. This allows up to 8 different frequencies to be generated from a single device. The device will configure itself from power up, so you can be providing output clocks at the frequency you need in your configuration before your software is even loaded or running. And of course, any functions that you don't end up using can be turned off to save power. The advantage of a highly integrated and flexible device like this, one additional advantage I should say, is that there is a reduced footprint on your PCB for this clock tree. We're able to generate high-performance clocks from any input frequency. This eliminates the need for a separation of frequency translators on the board and jitter attenuators. Those can be combined into a single device, generating the desired frequency and performance. As you can see from the block diagram, we're able to support the receive and transmit paths of a communications line card within a single device because it has two PLLs within it. Additionally, our fractional output divider technology, of which there are two within the devices, allow further independent frequencies to be generated for a total of 8 different output frequencies within a single device. The device architecture supports a digital PLL driving an analog PLL. This provides both flexibility and performance, and the use of the digital PLL will eliminate many external passive components that may otherwise have been needed, reducing the footprint. Each of the outputs on the device is independently programmable. The output protocols can be selected from one of a large list, and the voltages can also be driven independently for each of those outputs. This eliminates the need for external buffers in your system. So I just want to finish off here by saying we have a wide range of support tools for this product, including the Timing Commander software, and those can be accessed at the URL listed below. So I look forward to working with you and helping you solve your complex clocking problems simply.